In this video, we'll learn about the methods for using a simple standard deviation or simple variance to estimate the value of the corresponding population standard deviation or population variance. We will learn how to construct a confidence interval estimate of the population standard deviation or the population variance using the chi-square distribution.
Chi-square distribution is skewed to the right, unlike the normal and student t distribution that are symmetric about the zero. The values of chi-square can be zero or positive, but they cannot be negative. Chi-square distribution is different for each number of the degrees of freedom. As the number of degrees of freedom increases, the chi-square distribution approaches to normal distribution. The smaller the sample size, the more skewed to the right chi-square distribution is. To a statistic, chi-square can be found by the formula n, the sample size, minus 1, times the standard deviation of the sample squared divided by standard deviation of the population squared. We are going to be using table A4, StatCrunch, to find the critical value chi-square. Let's first go over some abbreviations. Population standard deviation is abbreviated as sigma. Variance is abbreviated as sigma squared. So basically, standard deviation is variance squared. This is a very important moment that we will need to use later when we use StatCrunch to build confidence interval estimate for population standard deviation. Sample standard deviation is abbreviated as S, and sample variance is abbreviated as S squared. So standard deviation of the sample is equal square root of the sample variance. The procedure for constructing confidence interval for population standard deviation or population variance are as follows. First, we need to verify that the two requirements are satisfied. The sample is a simple random sample, and the population is normally distributed. The requirement for the normality is much stricter for population standard deviation and population variance confidence intervals. Second step, using the degrees of freedom n-1, find the critical values chi-square right and chi-square left that correspond to the desired confidence level. Step 3, write the confidence interval estimate of population variance using the chi-square right and chi-square left critical values and the following formula. We'll use this formula to build a confidence interval manually, and then I'll show you how to use StatCrunch and TI-84 graphing calculator to build the confidence interval estimate for population variance and population standard deviation. To build a confidence interval estimate of population standard deviation, we just take square roots from both limits, because remember, standard deviation is equal to the square root of the variance. And lastly, round the confidence interval limits to one more decimal than the original data if using the original data set, or the same number of decimal places as the sample standard deviation if using the summary statistics. Let's read the example. Data set 7, called IQN Lead in Appendix B in our textbook. I put the reference in the video description. List the IQ scores for subjects in 3 different lead exposure groups. The 22 full IQ scores for the group with medium exposure to lead, group 2, have a standard deviation of 14.29263. Consider the sample to be a simple random sample and construct a 95% confidence interval estimate of population standard deviation from which the sample was obtained. Let's first check if the requirements are met. The first requirement is met. The sample is a simple random sample. Now we need to check for the normality of the distribution. I downloaded the dataset 7 IQN lead from data, load, shared datasets. The example is referring to the medium lead group, group 2. So I'm going to find group 2. There are 22 values in group 2. And I'm going to copy the IQ scores and check for the normality of the distribution, those IQ scores. Copy, paste in the next column. And then to check for the normality, we can use either histogram or quantile plot. Histogram is located under graphs. Compute. the histogram looks approximately normal. Now let's check the quantile plot. Go to graph, QQ plot, choose column var9, compute. Dots are scattered around the straight line and there is no specific pattern. So we can consider the distribution of these 22 IQ scores approximately normal. Now let's find standard deviation of this sample. I know standard deviation was given, but I still wanted to remind you how to find standard deviation from the sample. Go to summary stats, columns, column var9, standard deviation, compute. Standard deviation of this sample is 14.292628, rounded to one more decimal than the original data set, 14.3. We will look how to build a confidence interval estimate of population standard deviation and population variance manually and then using technology. Let's find the chi-square critical values. Our sample number is 22. Confidence interval is 95%. Let's draw chi-square distribution. Remember, it's not symmetric. It's skewed to the right distribution. The values start at a zero. This is the chi-square values. 95% or 0.95 confidence level will be located in the middle. Therefore, on both sides, we'll have different chi-square values. Chi-square left and chi-square right. That's why they call chi-square left limit and chi-square for the right limit. Let's use table A4. Table A4 is different in the way that we will need the areas to the right of the test statistic. So when we are looking for the critical value chi-square right, then the area to the right of chi-square will be 0.025. Remember how to find the areas in the critical regions? Well, if the confidence level is 95%, then we subtract 0.95 from 1, divided by 2, will give us 0.25 for both areas. And the area in the left critical tail is also 0.025. So when we look for chi-square left limit, we will need to subtract 1 minus 0.025, the area to the left, to find the area to the right of chi-square left, which is equal to 0.975. For table A4, we will need the degrees of freedom. Degrees of freedom is found by subtracting 1 from the sample size. The sample size is 22 minus 1, so degrees of freedom in our example is 21. Degrees of freedom located on the left side, the areas to the right of the critical value located in the top row, and the critical values itself are located in the middle of the table. The degree of freedom is 21. The area to the right of chi-square right is 0.025. So go down to locate chi-square right, 35.479. And the area to the right of chi-square left was 0.975. Go down to locate chi-square left, 10.283. In StatCrunch, chi-square distribution is located under Stat, Calculators, Chi-square. We need to identify degree of freedom, 21. First, let's find chi-square right. The area to the right of critical value chi-square is 0.025, 35.789. And when we look for chi-square left, we either put the area 0.025 and adjust the direction to the left of the critical value, compute 10.283, or if you leave the direction to the right, then the area to the right will be 0.975. I'm going to write down the critical values that we found, 10.283 and 35.479. We'll use these critical values to build the confidence interval for population standard deviation. We will first build the confidence interval estimate for population variance using the formula for confidence interval limits, n minus 1 times standard deviation of the sample squared divided by chi square right, 2n minus 1 times standard deviation of the sample squared divided by chi square left. Yes, The chi-square right is on the left and chi-square left is on the right. Because when we divide the number, the greater the denominator is, the smaller the number. And we want smaller number on the left and larger number on the right. And because chi-square right is larger and chi-square left is smaller critical value, we will switch these two critical values. N is 22 minus 1. Standard deviation of the sample is 14.29263 squared divided by chi-square right was 35.479. Do the same with the right limit. 22 minus 1 times 14.29263 squared divided by chi-square left was 10.283. The left limit is 120.9 and the right limit is 417.2. This is the confidence interval for population variance. To find the confidence interval for population standard deviation, we just take square root from left and from right limits. The confidence interval limits for population standard deviation are 11.0 and 20.4. We round the confidence interval limits to one more decimal because we use the original data, which were rounded to no decimals. To interpret the confidence interval for population standard deviation, we say that we are 95% confident that the limits of 11.0 to 20.4 do contain the true value of the population standard deviation. We can express the confidence interval limits as 11.0 to 20.4 in the interval notation, but we cannot express it in the form of standard deviation plus or minus error because the chi-square distribution is not symmetric distribution. We can use the StatCrunch to build the confidence interval estimate for population variance and population standard deviation. Technology makes this process much faster. We will use the same 22 IQ scores, and I'll show you how to build the confidence interval from data and from summary statistics. Go to Stat, Variance Stats, One Sample, With Data. Choose the column with our data, var 9, confidence interval. This will be the confidence interval for population variance. Compute. The confidence interval limits are 120.9 to 417.18. Let's copy these limits and insert it in one of the rows. Those are the limits for the population variance. Remember, standard deviation is the square root of the variance. So to find the confidence interval limits for the population standard deviation, we take square roots from both limits. The left limit will be 10.998 rounded to 1 decimal 11.0 and the right limit 417.18431 squared will be 20.4 rounded to 1 decimal. These are the interval limits for the population standard deviation. And to find the confidence interval limits for the population standard deviation and population variance from summary stats, go to Stat, Variance Stats, One Sample with Summary, enter the sample variance, which we are not given the sample variance. We can, of course, calculate it from Stat, Summary Stats columns. But if we are given the standard deviation, which was 14.29263, then we square the standard deviation to find the sample variance, 204.279. Sample size is 22. Confidence interval for variance, sigma squared, level 0.95, compute. We get the same interval limits for the population variance, and when we square them, we'll get the limits for the confidence interval of population standard deviation.
I hope you found this video helpful. In the next series of videos, we will start learning about testing the claim or hypothesis about population parameters. In the next video, we'll be testing a claim about population proportion, and then we'll move on to testing a claim about population mean, and next, testing a claim about population standard deviation. I'll see you soon.